Master Your Mindset Radio, Episode 7.
Welcome to Master Your Mindset Radio, the show where we empower you to conquer limiting beliefs and transform your world with your gifting and purpose. Now for your host, Elizabeth Nader.
Hey everyone, I want to talk to you today about the power of getting back up. I recently released my book, Master Your Mindset, The Master's Way, on Amazon. And in that book, the last chapter is called The Blessing of Failure. That happens to be the first chapter that I wrote. And I wrote it after I experienced a major failure in my life, a failure of something that had been extremely successful, a failure of a business that had won awards and done many things that were definitely something we should celebrate. And then the recession came and we had a massive failure in that business. It was such a difficult time for me. It was such a difficult time for my mindset. And I write about that in the chapter of how much I struggle with that. But the reason I'm here today and the reason why I'm now walking even more definitely in my purpose is because I decided to get back up. It wasn't easy, but that's what I decided to do. And I think when we look at our lives, we have a tendency to see ourselves defined by either our successes or our failures. But I would say to you, we need to celebrate more than a success, more than looking at a failure. We need to celebrate when we got back up, because those are the moments that define us. Those are, in fact, the moments that make us the people that we should be. Those are the moments that we should talk about. Now, we do that when it comes to larger figures. We do that when you think about famous people, when you think about the stories of successes that you know that you can tell. And I write about some of these in my book. When you think about these people, almost always the story of what they've achieved and accomplished comes packaged in some kind of failure or loss or setback. And we seem to celebrate the fact that they got back up, but we don't tend to do it in our lives. I mean, if Thomas Edison took 10,000 times to get back up to finally develop the light bulb, we all celebrate the fact that he didn't quit. And that's the story that we tell kids in elementary school. If Abraham Lincoln had given up after so many attempts to run for office, after business failures, after relationship failures, after mental health issues, but he kept getting back up and became one of the greatest figures in our country's presidency. There are stories about business people who almost lost everything or lost everything, but got back up and ended up changing the world with a unique idea or creativity or something that today changes our lives. There are stories about athletes who were cut, who were down for the count, who were injured, whatever it is, but they got back up and ended up being the best at what they do. And so we tend to, in larger than life figures, we tend to celebrate the fact that they got back up, but not so much in our own lives, not so much in the everyday man. But isn't that in fact the thing that changes everything? Isn't in fact the idea that we can get back up? Isn't in fact the process of getting back up what should be what we look at, what we should celebrate? Because that is what makes all the difference. We can talk about our successes. We can talk about where we fell down. But what's interesting is when we decided to get back up. And not everybody does it. Not everybody does get back up. But that's what I'm encouraging you to do. That is the point of having a strong mindset, is your ability to get back up from the things that you face. And I think that if we start to celebrate that more in our lives, we start to recognize that every day sometimes we need to do a little bit of that. We start to recognize that when we're trying to walk in our purpose, resistance comes against us. When we're trying to do something for the greater good, when we're trying to be who we're designed to be, we meet resistance. And that resistance would like to keep us down. And it can be small things every day. It can be big things that other people see. You know, every day we meet people who are fighting battles, who are facing resistance. We don't always know it. But the idea that they can get back up is what humanity, the struggles of humanity and the success and the inspiration of humanity is all about. Look at the Rocky movies. Now, I have to bring him up because my kids love the Rocky movies. And Lori, this is for you because you know how much you love Rocky. But really, those movies are so inspirational. And I laughed at myself because I ended up writing about him in the failure chapter. But I certainly saw those movies when I was younger. And they're kind of cheesy and formulaic. And, you know, in some ways, you know what's going to happen. But I think that they hit on a deeper tone within us. I think that there's something in humanity that the Rocky movies really, really tap into. And that's the idea of getting back up. So much so that it's literal. In fact, in Rocky II, I believe it is, Rocky is fighting Apollo Creed. And after so many punches being thrown, after so much effort and so much attempt to beat the other person, both men are bloodied and beaten and exhausted. And they're both on the mat. They're both down for the count, if you will. And now we have a matter of which one is going to get back up, because the person that simply gets back up is the man who wins. Nothing else at this point. No more punches to be thrown. No more attempts at anything to be made. Really, no more talent to be used. No more training to be put in use and to show off how hard you've trained for months and months for this fight. No more strategy to use. Just get on your feet and you win. And that becomes the climax of that entire scene, is who is going to get back up. And of course, Rocky is the one who gets back up. I mean, barely. Apollo Creed almost gets back up and falls back down. And then ultimately Rocky gets back up and we all scream and celebrate and cheer. But that's what I'm saying. In your life every day, there are moments where you have to get back up. They may not be on a world stage like that. They may not be in such a dramatic fashion, but you and I both know we have moments every day where we have to say to ourselves, come on, keep going and get back up. In fact, in another one of the movies, Rocky is talking to his son. And I just want to read to you a little quote from that, because it's exactly what I'm talking about. Us looking at how we want to face the challenges that life brings to us. And he says, "The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It is a very mean and nasty place, and it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward, how much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done." I love it. I love the simplicity of that. What he's basically saying is get back up. What he's basically saying is it's not what comes against you, it's how you respond to it. Isn't that the basis of mindset after all? Don't we talk about that all the time? Aren't I constantly saying, hey, the only thing you can control is your mind and your attitude and how you decide to look at something? And that really is about getting back up, is how we respond to life's issues, how we respond to the things that come against us. When we decide in small ways and big ways to get back up. And that's what we should celebrate. And we look at our lives and we can look at moments of success, we can look at moments of failure. But if you really think about it, the turning points for us, even in small ways, are when we decide to get back up. So I want us to celebrate that. That's why this podcast is about the power of getting back up. It's simple, but it's profound. We don't want to be stuck at the place of our last failure and never get up from our knees. We don't want to do that. We don't want failure to be the period at the end of our sentence. It can definitely be a pause and punctuation, a comma, a semicolon, a dash, but not a period. It can't be the end. It can be a moment where we catch our breath. It can be a moment where we really, really reevaluate our lives, a moment where we try to look at things differently. But ultimately, in order for us to walk in our purpose, in order for us to change the world around us, in order for us to be who we were designed to be, we have to get back up. So think of a crowd cheering you on when you even feel you're alone and no one sees you. Imagine there's a crowd cheering you on saying, get back up. Even in small ways today, get back up. Literally step out and decide that you are going to push forward again no matter what comes against you. So I hope this encourages you. Maybe you can even hear the Rocky theme in your head if you need to. Hey, whatever it takes, box in the mirror if you need to. Something to say to yourself, I'm not done. It's not over. Not even close. I am getting back up in every way, every day, in big things and small things, because I was created on purpose and for a purpose. And I refuse to let that go in my life. I will figure out what I'm supposed to do, and I will continue to get back up and push through resistance no matter what faces me, because I'm worth it and because everyone around me needs whatever God put inside of me. Also, look at the people around you. Remember, they're struggling too. Encourage people around you to get back up whenever you can. When we share more of what we go through, when we're willing to be a little more honest and a little more transparent about our struggles, then I think a lot of times people around us feel like they can do it as well. So share that. Encourage others to get back up and fight for your purpose. Have a great week. Come visit me on social media. Visit me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Tell me what you think about this message and leave me a review on the podcast. It would be really, really helpful. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss another episode. I've got a great interview coming up that is all about getting back up in the face of extreme loss. God bless you guys. Have a wonderful week, and I'll be with you soon.
Thank you for listening to Master Your Mindset Radio. Before you go, if you want to be part of a free online community of like-minded individuals for support, resources, and inspiration as you conquer your limiting beliefs and pursue your purpose, go to elizabethnader.com/community. That's elizabethnader.com/community. Or search for Master Your Mindset Academy private group on Facebook. Looking forward to seeing you online.